I'm Judy Nichols, and I teach in the English department. And I was going to read you Elizabeth Bishop's The Shampoo. The still explosions on the rocks, the lichens grow by spreading gray concentric shocks. They have arranged to meet the rings around the moon, although within our memories they have not changed. And since the heavens will attend as long on us, you've been, dear friend, precipitate and pragmatical. And look what happens, for time is nothing if not amenable. The shooting stars in your black hair, in bright formation, are flocking where? So straight, so soon. Come, let me wash it in this big tin basin, battered and shiny like the moon. I often return to Bishop's poem, The Shampoo, because of what it teaches me about writing. Her precision as a poet observer comes through with the opening stanza, the still explosion on the rocks, the lichens. Her attention to very immediate landscape, the lichens and how they move, ground her and give her sure footing as the metaphors escalate to become about the moon and time. I think, you know, I return to the poem partly because of the fact that it's this bold love poem about love in middle age, the power and the self-assurance that she has, she takes partly from love and partly from language. As Bishop continues to explore time, she returns to the precise diction I associate with the first stanza, where she's this observer, and really interested in this sort of specific world. And since the heavens will attend as long on us, you've been, dear friend, precipitate and pragmatical. Apparently, Bishop only arrived at the words precipitate and pragmatical after many, many tries at describing her lover's famous impatience. I admire her, you know, willingness to use those words in a poem, and the sound play, the precision that help us sort of know the specific woman that Bishop loves. In the final stanza, we see how love and language give Bishop confidence and power as she appeals to the woman, and we get this beautiful last stanza. The shooting stars in your black hair, in bright formation, are flocking where? So straight, so soon? Come, let me wash it in this big tin basin, battered and shiny like the moon. Time, which is usually the enemy of love, eases up in this stanza, and gray hair becomes shooting stars. Time is redeeming. And Bishop, who's been careful, circumspect, somewhat formal up to this point, becomes confident with her command, come, let me wash it in this big tin basin. Bishop proposes enjoying sensual pleasure with this daily intimate act. Tin basins, you think of not necessarily here, but in Brazil, for bathing, they would have been used in a lot of homes. And so it sets the poem in Brazil. It also, the emblem of, you know, tin basins are a great emblem for sort of these women's knocked about lives. The invitation toward bathing and washing hair is made without shyness. She seems to sort of say, thanks to our encircling love, we have world enough in time. But I think finally her sort of faith in the details of ordinary daily life, for those images to become so central in her poems, that's what I've always sort of found in a lot of the poems that I go back to. That's what I hold on to. So.